This interactive simulation models diffusion of octane through a stagnant layer of air. So at the bottom is liquid octane. We're assuming that here we have vapor liquid equilibrium, and so the pressure of octane immediately above the liquid is equal to its saturation pressure. Z, the height that it has to diffuse through. The tube has a diameter of 28 centimeters, so that the representation is to scale. And what's important is we're looking at steady state diffusion, so it's happened long enough that we can get to steady state. And we have air that flows across the top, and so here the octane concentration is going to be zero. So concentration of octane is zero because of the air moving across. So we can change the total pressure, where most of the pressure, at least at low temperatures, is due to air. And here is plotted the mole fraction of octane versus tube height. Of course, this changes as we change the system temperature, because as we lower the temperature, of course, we're lowering the saturation pressure exponentially. The total pressure, of course, as we increase that, it also decreases the octane mole fraction. We can increase the tube height, and that, of course, will decrease the mass flow rate. So this is the total mass flowing out, 390 milligrams per second for these particular conditions, and this depends on tube height, total pressure, and the temperature. So let's look at the simulation. So here's the interactive simulation. You can see as we increase the height of the tube, we decrease the flux. As I lower the temperature, the flux goes down pretty dramatically. So down here, when a couple orders of magnitude lower at the low temperature, as I increase the pressure, now we have more air to diffuse through, and also the flux goes down. So the mole fraction, of course, is very low at this condition, and as I raise the temperature, the mole fraction becomes a significant bigger part, and then convective flux becomes more important at the higher temperature.